Let's start with a rectangle with a width of 8. And in it, let's inscribe the quarter circle and one smaller half circle so that they intersect in one point. Can you find the value of this shaded area with only information given? If you want to answer this question for yourself and try this one, you can pause the video right now and then come back to see the solution. Alright, let's solve this one. So first we are going to set our attention to these two circular segments. We will set the center of this smaller half circle as A, and we can set its radius to be R. Of course, the radius R will also be on the bottom side of the point A. Now we will set the center of this bigger quarter circle as B. You can notice that the yellow line represents the diameter of the smaller circle. And if we translate this line to the right, we can get the radius of a bigger quarter circle with a value of 2R. Now we can say that this red area is equal to the area of this smaller half circle plus the area of this bigger quarter circle. The area of our smaller half circle will be equal to 1/2 of the r squared y, and the area of our bigger quarter circle will be equal to 1/4 of the squared radius of our bigger circle, which in this case is 2r squared y. Now we can substitute those values in our first equation and we will get that the red area is equal to 1 over 2r squared pi plus 1 over 4 quantity of 2r squared pi. Now we can work through this equation. We can first simplify it as following. Then you can notice that we can simplify the second term with 2 in order to get the common denominator, like so. Now we can add these two terms together and get that the red area is equal to 3r squared pi over 2. Now we will pull a line AB. You can notice that this line crosses through the intersection point of these two circular segments, which we will mark as O. From here, it's easy to see that the line OA is equal to the radius of our smaller half circle with the value of r, and the line OB is equal to the radius of our bigger quarter circle with a value of 2r. That means that the length of the line AB must be equal to 3r. Now we can see that we can form this purple right triangle with a hypotenuse of 3r and the legs of r and 8. We can now use the Pythagorean theorem and say that the quantity of 3r squared is equal to r squared plus 8 squared. We can simplify this, and if we put the value of r squared on the left side of the equation, we will get the following. If we simplify this more, we will get that 8r squared is equal to 64, which means that r squared is equal to 8. Now we can plug this value back into the formula for the red area. And we will get that that is 3 times 8 pi over 2. We can of course simplify this and get that that is 12 pi. And this is the value for our red area. Now we can continue and calculate the radius. Since the r squared is equal to 8, that means that r is equal to square root of 8, which we can simplify and get that r is equal to 2 square root of 2. With this in mind, we can now calculate the area of our rectangle, since we know that the area of the rectangle is equal to the product of its length and height. So that means that in our case, that is 8 times 2r. Now we can substitute the value of r, which we got before, and we will get the following. Now, if we simplify this, we will get that the area of our rectangle is equal to 32 square root of 2. Now, it's easy for us to find the value of our wanted blue shaded area, since it will be equal to the area of our rectangle minus the red area of these combined two circular segments. we can write down this diagram as a formula to get the following. Now we can just substitute our values and we will get that the blue area is equal to 32 square root of 2 minus 12 pi, and of course you can approximate this to 7.55 squared units, and this is our solution. If you guys enjoyed this video, smash the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below for everyone to see. And of course, until next time, as always, see you guys and take care.